Once we have printed out our current information, we read a command. We're going to define an appropriate function, input command for that. And then we're going to invoke a function named debug with the command, with the current argument, and with all local variables. We have our debug function return a value named resume. If resume is false, we stay in this current event, that is, we do not proceed in our code. And if resume is true, then we exit the loop, step out of our traceIt function, and then execute the next line in the program. Let me first come up with a debugging function. It accesses the state of the debugger via these two global variables, stepping and breakpoints. If the command we have entered has an argument, then there should be a space between the command and the argument, and we get the argument by splitting the entire string, getting the second element in the resulting list, which is the argument. Otherwise, the argument is just none. Now we can check what the command actually is and what it should do. For instance, if we say S, or any command that starts with S, we want to step through the program. So what we do is we set stepping to true, such that in the next line the program will stop again. And we return true, such that after stepping, execution resumes and actually gets to the next line. We can now add more commands, for instance, continue in here, which sets the stepping variable to false and still asks the debugger to resume.